Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to our parish community of St. Mark the Evangelist as we celebrate Holy Mass on this, the fifth Sunday of Easter. In respect for today's liturgy, please silence your cell phones. The celebrant of today's Mass is Father Lou, assisted by Deacon Charlie. This Mass is being offered for the Mother's Day Novena of Masses. Please take home a copy of our bulletin to keep updated on all the activities here at St. Mark. The readings for today's liturgy can be found in our Journey Songs Missal at number 912.
Now let us all rise and worship the Lord in song. Welcome our celebrant. We welcome all those who are worshiping with us online. Together let us sing. Ye sons and daughters, let us sing.
King of heaven, the glorious King, o'er death today rose triumphing. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. That Easter morn at break of day, the faithful women went their way to seek the tomb where Jesus lay. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. An angel clad in white they see, who sat and spoke unto the three. Your Lord has gone to Galilee. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. That night the apostles met in fear. Amidst them came their Lord most dear, and said, my peace be on all here. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today, as we gather at the Lord's invitation, we hear Jesus' commandment to love one another again. Let us be grateful today for a God who loves us so much and pray for the grace to put this commandment of Jesus into action, whether it be toward family and dear ones, or toward strangers we encounter on the street. Let us learn to love one another as Jesus has loved us. My brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a reminder of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. O mighty and ever-living God, who will through water and the fountain of life, the source of purification, ever so every soul should be cleansed and receive the gift of eternal life. Be pleased, we pray, to bless this water by which we seek your protection on this day, O Lord. Before the living spring of your grace within us, grant us the water that may defeat from all evil and bodily harm. Let us approach you with hearts made clean and worthy receive your salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. And together let us worship the Lord.
River of glory, springs of harvest. and clothed in the light we are bathing the glory of God. Here there is heaven, healing and health, joy for the asking, love in abundance of wealth. River of glory, springs of our birth, flood of God's riches poured on the earth. We are born from the darkness, clothed in the light, we are breathing the glory of God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you are pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joy of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul and Barnabas had proclaimed the good news to that city and made a considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in the faith, saying, "It is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of heaven." They appointed elders for them in each church, and with prayer and fasting commended them to the Lord in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through the Pisidia and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the word at Perga, they went down to Attalia. From there, they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. And when they arrived, they called the church together and reported what God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. I will praise your name, my King and my God, my King and my God.
Everyone.
My King and my God, my King and my God.
A reading from the book of Revelation. Then I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw a holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Commandment I give you, love one another as I have loved you. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Judas had left them, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and God will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. I give you a new commandment: love one another. As I have loved you, so you also should love one another. This is how all will know that you are my disciples: if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Most of the people were so busy and so preoccupied that they actually missed a minor miracle that happened on a street corner that morning. An elderly couple stood there and waiting for the traffic light to change. Their white hair was blowing in the wind. Their hands were a bit shaky. She had a cane in her right hand. He had a cane in his left hand. They were stooped over a bit, and they were a little bit unsteady on their feet. But they went out for a walk every morning, and she in particular enjoyed that walk. And so they stood there on the corner, waiting for the light to change, so they could cross this fairly wide street in another block or two and they would be home again. And as the light began to change and they stepped off the curb, he reached out with his right hand, took her left arm, pulled her close to him. The light turned green. They stepped off the water, off the curb, and started to, you know, a little senior shuffle across the street. Unfortunately, it was a wide street, and they didn't get all the way across before the light changed again. And as soon as the light changed, horns began to beep, people began to scream out the window, and the passerby, so worried about their thing, so worried about where they were going, what they were going to do, never even noticed. But he never took his eyes off his wife, and he never let go of her arm. And as they continued to shuffle, and now they're dodging some cars that are in a real hurry, so they're not going to wait for them, she looked at him, and you could see the love in her face that she had for this man. Because despite his own wobbliness, he loved her enough to make sure that she was safely across that street. And when they got to the other side, all of those passerbys who were in such a hurry never saw that miracle of love that they had for each other. Those two people would have understood today's gospel. Because in the gospel today, Jesus reminds his disciples, and by reminding them, reminds all of us that people will know who we are by the love that we have for one another. And the way that we have that love, and the way that we let that love sink in, is because we remember how much God loves each one of us. And his love for us is so great that he sent his only son to show that love for us. He sent his only son to die a horrible death on the cross, to be able to go back, to open up the gates of heaven for each one of us. So as we gather here today and we celebrate this Eucharist, we pray that we remember the new command that Jesus gives us today's gospel. Love one another so that they will know who you are by the love that you have. And I, my Father, will love you. Let us now continue our celebration by renewing our baptismal promises as we do frequently during the Easter season. Brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in a newness of life. Now that a Lenten observance is concluded, we renew the promises of our holy baptism by which we renounce Satan and his works and promise to serve God and the church. And so I ask each one of these questions and ask you to answer, I do. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness for our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus for eternal life. God has made his dwelling with us, and he promises to make all things new. Counting on the Father's boundless mercy, we now pray.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, may we be known as disciples of Jesus through the love and care we show one another. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all world and civic leaders, may they be guided by God's love and mercy for us. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been displaced by war, especially the Ukrainians, may God protect them from harm, touch the hearts of many to reach out and assist them, and lead them to places of safety. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are gathered here today, may our faith in God's love for us be expressed in our love for one another. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christian husbands and wives, may they be strengthened in their loving commitment to one another, modeling the union of Christ and the church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they live forever with God's peace and love. We also remember those for whom this Holy Mass is offered. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions in our prayer book and the prayers present within the silence of our hearts. We also pray for the grace this week to love others as Jesus has loved us. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, teach us to love one another as you and your Son, Jesus, love us. Graciously grant this, our prayer, through the risen Lord Jesus Christ.
And now, as our gifts are presented and prepared, let us sing Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ.
to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice has made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but at this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful, for his death is our ransom from death, and his rising the life of all have risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy to be glorified, O Lord, who love the human race and always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and at once for the disciples, and now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask you to send forth the Holy Spirit to sanctify the gifts of the bread and the cup, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until it comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted today and until the day of eternity, among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By your partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm in us the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, the bishops, deacons, religious, and all your people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the time by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, St. Mark the Evangelist, all the saints who praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of your Holy Spirit, O glory and honor are yours forever and ever. At a Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Now, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. With the help of your mercy, be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I have called you, and you are mine.
bring you his care and his love. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine. I have called you and you are
mine. Love that's freely given wants to freely be received. All the love you poured on us can hardly be believed. And all that we can offer you is thanks. All that we can offer you is thanks. Creation tells a story that began so long ago, of love that longed to share its life in hope that love would grow. Sun repeats each morning, the story is retold, and just in love's retelling, new chapters yet unfold. For love that's freely given wants to freely be received. All the love you poured on us can hardly be believed. And all that we can offer you is thanks. All that we can offer you is thanks. Your care called out a people. Your love made them your own. You freed their hearts and calmed their fears. Finally brought them home. It's when our trials are ended we most easily forget. But your friendship never ceases, your love shows no regret. For love that's freely given wants to freely be received. All the love you've poured on us can hardly be believed. All that we can offer you is thanks. All that we can offer you is thanks.
We'd like to invite those who are bringing communion to those physically not able to be with us this morning to please come forward. As you go to the sick and the homebound, take with you not only the sacrament we have celebrated, but also the word of God which we have heard, as well as the affection of this parish community. Ask for the prayers of those whom you visit in return. Go now with God's peace and blessing. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have been imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We ask now if you bow your heads and ask for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in the right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is over. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us, make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. But let us find in you our unity so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father, the Son, forever and ever. Amen.